Hey guys, this is the SP Architect and in today's tutorial I'm going to show you how to make parametric floor design in ARCHICAD. You can think that why don't you use only simple image on the floor plan? Yes, you are right. But if you would like to change size or material, you will have to go Photoshop again and fix that. Or for example, you have borders for the floor and you want that floor to apply other rooms. It's kinda mess. Here in this video I'm gonna show you how to do that. At first, let's change the units to centimeter. It's at the options menu, project preferences and working units. Click this millimeter and click centimeter. OK. We start from making a room because I'm going to make this tiling in the room. I click the wall tool and click on the screen and input here 900 centimeters and 600 centimeters. I hit the shift while moving the mouse to make a perpendicular line. At very first, I want to show you a conventional way how to decorate the floor. We are going to sketch first. This is the control box that we are going to use for offsetting. You can open this at the options menu. Here I click the tool and click the space with spacebar and input an offset distance. After that, we need a reference image for this. I'm just going to import at the file menu. External content, place external drawing. Select all available files. For example, let's choose this one. Double click it or click OK. After that, place it on the screen. Here this box, we can scale it up or down. Just move this in the room and scale down to 10%. I click this corner and click this corner. The conventional way is this. We are going to use slab tool and make sketch on the pattern. We can use trim, split, extend tools for this workflow. Once we did this, we can apply materials and copy this to all room one by one. That sounds nice, sometimes useful. But what if you would like this pattern to use for another L-shaped room? Probably we will spend too much time for that and there must be another way. Just let's get rid of this. And this. To achieve this parametric floor plan design, we are just going to use curtain wall tool. Then select this one. By this tool, we can make drawings on any working planes. We are just going to go to scheme and delete this with minus button. And this one too. We need only one simple box for that. Now we are going to disappear these frames. Go to frames option and click this frame. Hit the remove button and click other frame. So we make them one. As we see in this reference picture, this mullion frame will match with tile joints. So I'm just gonna input here a close value for that distance, like 3 centimeters. For this thickness, let's input here 2 cm. And make this 0. Then click OK. Now we are going to create the room's corner. Or you can just hit spacebar. Once we complete this, let's go to 3D. Here we have a basic tiling. We can modify this tiling as we desire. At very first, we will make border. Select this and press Ctrl plus D. We are going to see here boundary frames. Once we click this, we will input to this box 25 cm. For the starting offset 0, for the thickness 2 cm, for this box, I input 0. Now we have border here inside the room, but some part is a little outside. To fix this, we are going to move main settings. Here we have boundary options that we can fix this. Now it fits the room totally. Let's change the materials. Press Ctrl plus T and go to frames, then click Mullion. Here we have settings. I can select from here or click here by activating. Let's choose gold. I go to panels, click main panel and open this one. And select from here, for instance this one. And go OK. Panel didn't change, so I go to settings again, click the scheme and click from here. I want to make them on the same level. Let's go to settings, frames. Here this box I leave this to, change this one to 0. It's a little higher. Let's fix this again. Let's try 1 cm. There we go. We have a nice base for our design. Let's change the boundary material. Click the boundary frame this time and click override surface. Then I choose this one. Now it is time to use our reference image. We are going to edit inside part of the curtain wall tool and create our pattern. To achieve that, we need to go to floor plan. Once we are at the floor plan, we just move this to other story. We need some transparency to sketch on the pattern. Therefore, we change this story and make reference. We are going to move here and click this and trace reference. Then we click this arrow in the opening menu. We check this figure option on. Finally, we hit this eye from transparency. We can see clearly our reference image. Once we have this, we are going to sketch onto this with line tool, or you can directly make your frames onto this. If I hit this button, visible stories will switch together. After that, you can place your pattern correctly on the tiling. You just need to duck this onto the corner and hit Ctrl plus K on keyboard, then click OK. First, draw a reference line. After that, draw your target line. Now we have placed this one totally fit. Once you have this, just go to other floor by this. Here, I have made these lines with line tool. I have only draw repeated parts, so that I have gained some time. Once we have this, we are just going to click the floor and we are going to see this edit. If you click this, you are going to see further and custom editing options right here. You can directly delete these unnecessary frames on the floor plan without broken other tiled frames. I want to make exact same this frame, therefore I alt click this frame and draw on the current lines which I make. It is a little hard to see these lines because it is gray. It can be easier if you would make them another color. We are just click on the reference lines so that this will be easier. For nice snapping to corners and right angles. As you can realize, they stack each other and I press Ctrl plus A to select all. They are going to be highlighted as green. By doing this, we can clearly see difference with done or undone. There we go. We are just going to click this pattern. You will see this pattern making box right here. I click this box and edit for proper matching to our pattern. I just click these edges and change the position of that. As we carry these edges, you will see that red highlighted frames inside the box so that we can easily understand which part of the frames belong to the pattern. Sometimes I cannot move some edges, especially corner edges. I click this move button here and move the total pattern. Let's just zoom in and click this offset edge. carry this edge to finishing point of the repeated corner. And for the this line, I cannot click this one. I think the real line is here. I need to click this one. And click this corner. These two opposite corners will stick together in tiling and create a complete pattern. There we go. Just let's be sure that we drag this edge to correct position. Let's look at what we have. I click this apply button. Very good. We have done our frames was duplicated all over the floor and created our pattern inside. Let's do a final check if there was a mistake or missing for the pattern. There is a missing frame here. I just make here another. Once we have this, we need to refresh the pattern. We are going to click red edge and reposition on the same place. Okay, we can quit from here and can get rid of these lines. Let's go to 3D. We have done this parametric tiling pattern design for our floor. Here we have a mistake. To fix that, I just go to settings. Here you can see these dimensions were automatically changed. But before that, let's create some panel type. Because we are going to assign different materials, each different type. Let's go to panels. Click add. Input here a name. Go to surface settings. Let's choose this one. Add again, input another name, choose surface. Let's go to scheme. We are going to assign these panels. Click the part and select the new panel from here and select this one. Move here and select other one. We can assign each part different surface. I want to make each one with different color before clicking OK. I go to panels, once new panel selected, change its structure from here, for example this, and other one too. I select this one, click OK. Here we have some problems. As you can see, unfinished patterns are covered with different surface. And we are going to fix inside surface. Let's go to settings. Here we have an option to change this unfinished surface. From this part we are going to select partial pattern, then I click this part and choose from here. This time color was changed. We can continue to changing. For example, click this one. Choose from here, select this one, choose from here, this one, and this. I am trying to make here a nice looking order and select them one by one. Finally, I hit the OK. Okay, we have got our design finished. It's completely parametric, rebuildable, and time-saving for big projects. I want this to try another shaped room to control. I just make another room, but L-shaped this time. I am just going to go to floor plan, and turn off the referencing, then copy this walls to here. I am going to turn off grouping too, so that I can add point here, and extrude this wall to make an L shape. Once we did this, I click this floor while alt clicking and click the inside with spacebar. Okay, let's look at what we have in 3D. Very nice. You can see that border turned inside the room correctly and our room was nicely fulfilled with our pattern. Let's add more color and surface for this design. Just need to add another panel type and change its surface just before. Ctrl plus T, panels, click add and input a name. I click panel settings, click surface, and choose this one. As you can see, we have three types now. I just go to scheme, select this one, and select this. This one is okay. No need to change. And click okay. We can see our new surface now. I think this technique is very procedural and very complicated designs can be made. To see more clear, we can turn off the visual lines from visibility options. Just click this 3D styles and in the opening menu, we just uncheck this and click OK. OK, you have learned how to make parametric floor design. You can use this and add your favorites and use your designs. If you want to download this or any of my projects, check out my Patreon, first link in the description. And you can download all of my project files so far. Okay, that's pretty much it and I'll see you in the next video.